Hey, Cross family, how's
Hi.
it going?
Corona nudge.
Yeah, Corona nudge. You know, we're here, and Layla just woke up. We were just about to record, and she woke up. So,
so she's in the video.
So she's in the video. We just wanted to tell you, we miss you guys.
Yeah, we do.
And we miss seeing everybody yesterday. It was lonely in the theater. And of course, as you heard with the president's new declaration, the next 15 days, you know, no parties of 10 or more. So we want to all do our part to help that out. And obviously the CDC has recommended nothing over 50 for the next 8 weeks. So we're basically in a new place in our lives as far as work, as far as family, as far as church. And, but, you know, we want to keep connecting with you.
Yeah.
And so the I did a little story on Instagram. The sound didn't come out great because it was so windy. But we were at the beach for the last beach because they just closed down the beach today. You know, we were trying to show the sunrise and bring a little peace. I shared Philippians chapter 4, verse 6, you know, don't be anxious about anything, but in everything with prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, present your request to God, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your heart and mind in Christ Jesus.
Yep.
And so, obviously, that's what we want to do. We want to continue to pray, continue to seek God, continue to, you know that He is in control, that when we're anxious, when we're fearful, we can present our request to Him, and He cares for us. And so, we want to give Him thanks, too. I think give Him thanks for the little things, the health. Maybe you've got health. Give Him thanks for that. Give Him thanks for all the health workers out there, and pray for all them, because they're doing an incredible job working hard for all of us that maybe have to go to the hospital or something happens. And so obviously we want to take time in our lives to give thanks, to cry out to God, whatever that may be in your life that you want to cry out to Him about, and just ask Him for help. You know, I was looking at Layla today, you know, she knows nothing about the coronavirus, as your kids know nothing about the coronavirus, the little ones like this, right? And so she's just dependent on us. She's dependent on us for food. She doesn't care about the news. She doesn't care about Instagram. She doesn't care about anything. And yet she wakes up with a smile and has a happy face and knows that, hey, when she cries, she gets food. So in the same way, we have to go to the Lord with that heart of a child and say, Lord, this is what's on our heart. This is where we're at. This is what the things we need to see happen. You know, Lord God, please help us and provide for us and heal our land. Obviously, yesterday was a national day of prayer, President Trump declared, and we want to continue to pray every day.
Yeah.
We want to pray that God would give these guys wisdom to find a cure for a vaccine for the future, but certainly for God to do a miracle in this whole epidemic, this pandemic, and that God would heal our land and heal the lands of Europe and all over the world. So we wanted to come and just say hi and just kind of connect, and also just be able to say, hey, we are praying for you and we miss you guys. We look forward to when we are able to get back. You know, that verse in Hebrews talks about don't forsake the assembling of the brethren. You know, it's like, all right, so how do we do that, Lord? Because we know how important it is. God made us for a relationship, you know, and so how do we do that? Well, like for a small group this week, we're not going to be in person. We'll do it via Zoom video conference. I'll send out a link tomorrow for that. So if you want to try to get on that, we'll see how that works. Certainly for any prayer requests you have, you can send them in to us. And you can email me, greg@thecrossfl.org, or you can email heather@thecrossfl.org. Email us and let us know. You can always fill out a prayer request on our app or online, but we want to know what's going on, and then we can share those prayer requests during our evening kind of dialogue with you, and just kind of touch base point and just see how everybody's doing. So,
Greg.
Yes.
So, if someone wants to be a part of the C group,
yes,
where do they let you know that they want to receive the link for the C group?
Well, this is going out to everybody that's got an email. So, if somebody else that isn't on email, they need to just email us and say, hey, we'd like to be on that list. So greg@thecrossfl.org. And we'll put all the information on the website and Facebook And that's the one good thing. There's all sorts of good stuff out there.
Yeah, and then there was said on Sunday, which is such an important thing to remember, that the church isn't a building.
No.
I think Cassie said that, you said that. And it's so true. We are still a church.
Yep.
So we just need to figure out, and like Greg is doing, being just creative about how do we hang out.
Yeah, and just encourage one another, pray for one another. Yeah. What are your prayer requests? You know, go ahead and you can text me too. You can text me your prayer requests. That's probably easier, right?
For me as well.
954-214-7348. So feel free to text me, 954-214-7348. And man, if there's any needs like prayer, we want to help out. And obviously, let us know the needs that you know of people maybe in our body that they need some help, they need some prayer, maybe they need some assistance. Maybe there's people that need food or delivered to their house or something like that. But we would like to know that. And so we can be the body and try to reach out and help out as much as we can. So basically, that's our time together. We, once again, don't be anxious about anything, you know, the word says, but in everything, man, we got to pray with thanksgiving. Continue to give God thanks. And we know God's going to give us a peace that transcends all understanding, just like this little one's got right here. She's got no worries at all.
Except when she's hungry.
Except when she's hungry,
and then
yes.
She gets
yes. But, oh, there we go. She's waving to you guys. So that she's telling me, be quiet, time to leave. All right. We love you. I'm going to pray right now, and then we'll say goodbye. Heavenly Father, we thank you for everybody. I thank you for all of our church. I thank you for those that are even watching this and maybe not part of our church. You bless them and bless their family, bless our church's family, God. We thank you for each person. I pray you protect us from any sickness, any problems, anything going on, God. We ask for your help and your wisdom and your guidance for our country. Pray for the leadership, our president, and all the people working with them, that you would help them discover a cure. A vaccine for the virus, and also, Lord God, that you would just give really, truly good leadership and what the next steps are for us. And we thank you that we've got sort of a roadmap now, and Lord, we can walk in it. And Lord, by walking in it, we're just showing our love for one another. And so, Lord, help us to love one another. And this is a sacrificial time, but it'll be a beneficial time. So, Lord, help us to build up our families, build up our lives, and strengthen, Lord, our core of who we are as Christians. Mm-hmm. God, I thank you for each person out there with kids. I pray you'd bless them with safety for their children, mm-hmm. safety for them as parents, safety mm-hmm. for the grandparents that are out there. God, we know that those with immune compromised systems, Lord, we pray for them that you would keep them healthy and strong. And Lord God, more than anything, give us wisdom each day as we walk out there. If we're going to work, Lord, protect people. If we have opportunities where we can work at home, awesome, Lord. But I just pray, God, that you would please lead and guide each person according to your spirit, according to your plan. And God, more than anything, continue to fill our hearts with joy, knowing that you still sit on the throne, that you can give us that peace that transcends all understanding. And Lord, you can do a miraculous, mighty work through all of this. You're going to grow us up big time and help us long for that fellowship together, Lord, and that family. And so we thank you for the authentic family that is the Cross Church. I pray you continue to pour out your blessings on everyone and protect them. And Lord, protect all those hospital workers, nurses, especially there's people in our church that are nurses and doctors. I pray, God, please have your hand of protection around them and all over the world.
Yeah.
And Lord, give us wisdom. And Lord, heal our land, please. Mm-hmm. God, forgive us of whatever, Lord, sin we have committed. We've committed a lot in our country. I know that. So we're sinners. So we just come to you and God, please forgive us and heal our land. And we thank you, God, that you hear our cry. Thank you that you care. Thank you that you're with us and you're never going to leave us or forsake us. And we pray it all in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
All right, you guys. Well, we're looking forward to seeing you again via video. And we'll keep you posted on the upcoming C group. And so from all of us, little Layla, you going to say goodbye? You want to go say goodbye to everybody?
You know what? I have one more thing.
Yeah.
For the people who are alone, who don't live with anyone.
Yes.
I just felt like that must be really tough.
Big time.
So it's a good thing that we have FaceTime.
Yeah.
And so if anyone Was feeling alone, really alone. Obviously, God is with you at all times, but we are community and being together. So reach out to us, you know, if you feel just alone, you know.
Please.
So that you can feel like you're company.
That's a great idea, Gaby. You know, and I thought about that earlier. If you're a single person, you don't have kids, and you're by yourself, you don't have roommates, man, you know what? Connect with us. Connect with me. Connect to, you know, you want to chat, you want to FaceTime, whatever it may be, but let's make sure that we stay connected. And we don't want you to feel like you're on an island by yourself. So, for sure. Can stay connected as much as we can. And for those of you who know people like that, man, stay connected with them.
Yep.
You know, and make sure that there is some community that happens. You can still, obviously, they can still meet in less than groups of 10, I guess. If you do have a friend maybe nearby, you can always hang out. So. Yeah. I know it.
Blah, blah, blah. We're getting long-winded.
Okay. All right. God bless you guys and have an awesome day. We'll talk to you again soon.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.